Good morning, and welcome to our liturgy. Ash Wednesday begins our 40-day season of Lent that leads to Easter. On Ash Wednesday, we come together like the people of the Old Testament to remind ourselves that we don't always follow God's ways and need to ask God for his mercy and forgiveness. Like God's people in the time of the prophets, we wear ashes to show that we want to turn away from sin and to have a change of heart, so that we can live as God calls us and to be kind and merciful to each other. Lent is a time for us to slow down and examine our conscience, to look at how we can become closer to God by prayer, fasting, and almsgiving.
Good morning. Please join in singing our opening song found in your student hymnal at number 137, Come and Journey with a Savior, number 137 in the student hymnal. Please stand and join in singing.
Together we make our Lenten prayer in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may begin with holy fasting this campaign of Christian service, so that as we take up battle against spiritual evils, we may be armed with weapons of self-restraint. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Prophet Joel. Even now, says the Lord, return to me with your whole heart, with fasting and weeping and mourning. Rend your hearts, not your garments, and return to the Lord, your God. For gracious and merciful is he, slow to anger, rich in kindness, and relenting in punishment. Perhaps he will again relent, and leave behind him a blessing. Offerings and libations for the Lord your God. Blow the trumpet of Zion. Proclaim a fast, call an assembly, gather the people, notify the congregation, assemble the elders, gather the children and the infants at the breast. Let the bridegroom quit his room and the bride her chamber. Between the porch and the altar, let the priest, the minister of the Lord, weep and say, spare, O Lord, your people, and make not your heritage a reproach. with the nations ruling over them. Why should they say among the peoples, where is their God? Then the look was stirred to concern for his land and took pity on his people, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the book of the prophet. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we are ambassadors for Christ. As if God were appealing through us, we implore you on behalf of Christ. Be reconciled to God. For our sake, he made him to be sin who did not know sin, so that we might become the righteousness of God in him. Working together, then, we appeal to you not to receive the grace of God in vain. For he says, in acceptable time I heard you, and on the day of salvation I helped you. Behold, now is a very acceptable time. Behold, now is the day of salvation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Take care not to perform righteous deeds in order that people may see them. Otherwise, you will have no recompense from your heavenly Father. When you give alms, do not blow a trumpet before you as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets to win the praise of others. Amen, I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you give alms, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your almsgiving may be in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will repay you. When you pray, do not be like the hypocrites who love to stand and pray in the synagogues and on street corners so that others may see them. Amen, I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you pray, go to your inner room, close the door, and pray to your Father in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will repay you. When you fast, do not look gloomy like the hypocrites. They neglect their appearance so that they may appear to others to be fasting. Amen, I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you fast, anoint your head and wash your face, so that you may not appear to be fasting, except your Father who is hidden. And your Father who sees what is hidden will repay you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord. So, happy Lent. Let's use well the gift of this holy time. The gospel tells us that this is the season that's marked with prayer and fasting and almsgiving. Disciplines, not punishments. Disciplines, the same root as disciples, that which will help us to grow closer to our God. But the gospel also tells us, don't be hypocrites. Let our thoughts, our words, and our actions this season help us to be better Christians, better followers of the Lord. Help us to grow towards Easter together as people of faith, not as hypocrites. The season marks us with a cross, a call to repentance, and an invitation to believe in the gospel. We move towards the promise of Easter, of resurrection and new life. And we mark the foreheads of those who willingly choose to accept the disciplines to pray, to fast, and to give alms. O God, who desire not the death of sinners, but their conversion, mercifully hear our prayers, and in your kindness, be pleased to bless these ashes, which we intend to receive upon our heads, that we who acknowledge that we are but ashes and shall return to dust, may through a steadfast observance of Lent gain pardon for sins and newness of life after the likeness of your risen Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever. We invite those assisting in the distribution of ashes to please come forward. Repent. repent and believe in the gospel.
Please join in singing from your student hymnal, number 187, Merciful God, number 187.
Merciful God, Jesus.
marked with the sign of the cross. We recall our Lord's sacrifice as we seek God's graciousness and mercy.
For Pope Francis and all bishops and priests, may the grace of God be with them in their Lenten practices. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our St. John of the Cross parish family, as we celebrate the start of Lent, may we be faithful in our fasting, almsgiving, and prayer. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in our community during this Lenten season, may grow in charity and be constant in prayer. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer due to homelessness, may God hear their prayers and may people continue to help support these families and individuals in whatever way they can. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, may the Christ, the divine vision, heal and bring consolation to their suffering. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, especially Scott Stapleton, Patrick Wagner, and Lewis Cote, may they enjoy the fullness of eternal life with God in heaven. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Throughout this Lenten season, let us pray for those who prepare for sacraments of initiation at the next Easter Vigil, including our catechumen, Randy. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Lord our God, hear these prayers as we mark the beginning of our Lenten journey of conversion. Through Christ our Lord. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the cause of the Church.
Amen. we solemnly offer the annual sacrifice for the beginning of Lent, we entreat you, O Lord, that through the works of penance and charity, we may turn away from harmful pleasures and, cleansed from our sins, may become worthy to celebrate devoutly the passion of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For through bodily fasting, you restrain our faults, raise up our minds, and bestow both virtue and its rewards through Christ our Lord. Through him, the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and gave you thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Blaise, our Bishop, and all of the clergy. Remember also our brothers and our sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. And all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with John of the Cross, and with all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our
Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done,
on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus the Christ, for the kingdom and the power of the Lord. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other the sign of Christ's peace. Peace with you, Father. God bless you. Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Singing our communion song found in our student hymnal at number 186, Lead Me Earth. Mercy, O God, number 186.
Let us pray. May the sacrament we have received sustain us, O Lord, that our Lenten fast may be pleasing to you and be for us a healing remedy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Please bow for the blessing. Pour out a spirit of compunction, O God, on those who bow before your majesty. And by your mercy, may they merit the rewards you promise to those who do penance. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend on you and remain with you forever.
Go forth and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
As we are sent forth, please join in singing our closing song, found in your student hymnal at number 174, Lead Me, Guide Me, number 174.